I'm Enzo Lefort, I'm doing foil and I'm from France. When I won the World Championships, I was 27 years old. Actually, the season wasn't that good for me. From November to March, I was struggling with my fencing. It helped me to find other ways to improve. 2 weeks before the World Championships, I injured myself. I couldn't fence. I couldn't do any sport. 2 days before to fly to Budapest, I did one lesson for a test, so it was okay. I did one fencing session with my teammates. I lost my free match against all my teammates. For my first match during the individual event, I was like, okay, no, I don't know where am I with my fencing, so I just do simple things. During the day, match after match, I extend my range of actions. When you go to the final, it means that you're in a good shape this day. So I was at this point, I was confident with my fencing. Final, it was against Marcus Mepstead that I know really well too. We fence a lot. First time I fencing, he was in junior, maybe 12 years ago. The way that I did the first touch was really what the best scenario ever. This is like my special touch, you know, when I do a flash and I hit under the arm of my opponent. So when it works, it's going to be a good match. I told so I can fence from longer distance, so I try to stick with that plan, and the plan went really well. At one point in the match, Marcus actually had to pause a lot because Marcus had some trouble with his foil. When there are breaks into a match, I think I try to focus on what I have to do. I try to remember maybe the past few touches to see how I can improve. But it really depends. When it's a 10-minute break, it's not it's really important to take a mental break, you know, because you can't stay focused the whole 10 minutes. So I let my escape. And when they are coming back into my match and I started to focus again. The thing with fencing is there are a lot of uncertainty. That's the main thing I love in fencing. You know, you can do 100 times the same action. Your opponent will never react the same way. When I come back from the 1 minute break, I hit 2 straight points. It was because my coach just told me to keep the same dynamics, to don't change anything because I was leading. At this point, the match was going really good for me. My attack was going in. I was succeed to defend his attack. And because in fencing, until you hit the last point, you never win. So I was like, okay, you are the keys. Don't mess it up. At 14-4, I did a mistake. I think about the fact that I was one touch away to become world champion. And if I remember, I took 2 or 3 touches from Marcus. I think I tried to do my signature move, which is the flash, but it was just because it's something I do on automatic mode. Marcus defended really well. So after that, I say, okay, do not try the easy way, try the real way. The real way was to see an opportunity and just just hit Marcus. So I remember Marcus came at me and I did a parade riposte, and that was it. It's weird, but at the beginning it was a relief because I was leading the whole match, and there is always a little voice inside your head who is saying, don't mess it up. The first thing that I thought was, okay, they're winning at me, okay, I have to drop my foil. When I was warranted by my team, it was at this moment that I realized that I was a world champion. Like your mind is outside your body or something like this. You can see your body from the outside. It's really weird, actually. I think if I didn't win this World Championship, I would be more like, okay, I lost an occasion to win something and I'm getting older and older, so maybe I lost a chance or something. But now this win get me more serenity. Obviously, this is the biggest win of my career so far, so I'm still starving, I'm still hungry to win more because it gave me the test, you know. I wiped myself into a legacy in French fencing, so now I can just go to win other medals.